So let's look at editing a program. For edit, at the top here we have cut, copy, paste, and delete. So if I highlight this point, and then just come up here and press copy, then paste, you see we've duplicated that line. To delete the line, have it highlighted, press delete, it will ask you for confirmation. Confirm, we have the point deleted. Same thing with cut, point is highlighted, cut, but if we come over here to paste, it works just like any Windows application. If you cut something, it goes on the clipboard, and then you can paste it. We can continue to paste it until we cut or copy something else. All right, I'm going to delete that line. But what happens if I want multiple lines? What I want is the approach point, the weld, and the clearance point. So I'm going to highlight where I want to start, and that's at the approach point, and then come here and check multi-select. Once I have multi-select, I can then select multiple lines, hit copy, come down to line 8 because it's going to insert below the cursor, and hit paste. And now we have those additional lines in the program. Now these are just duplicates of the original line. So let's talk about updating the position. And I'm going to highlight my point. I'm going to move to it. And I want to start here. And I just have to make sure the line is highlighted. Press update position. The position is now updated. Highlight this point. I'm going to move in. The point is highlighted. Press update. I won't make it as long. Point is highlighted. Update. And update. So we've updated this entire program. We go move to, and then run. Here is the original line. And then here's the line that we did the copy and paste and updated the positions. Now for this one, I don't want weaving, so I'll come in, highlight the start of the weld, uncheck weaving, save, and now it's no longer weaving. Okay. And at any point, we can come in and we can update the weld parameters. So I took the weave off. If I wanted to travel faster, I would just come in and go to 30. It started at the home. I'm going to have it end at the home, so I'm just going to copy that home, go all the way to the bottom, and paste. Right? So now if I press and hold, now if we go to the top and run, starts at home, goes into the first line, does the weave, goes to the second line, doesn't weave, and then returns to home. Let's take a deeper look into section 3 of our pendant. These are the edit parameters. You can see we have tabs here, well process, and if we highlight a line, it gives us the parameters here, and these are just the default parameters. When we first started the program, we put in parameters. That's what these parameters are. The default crater is telling us if it's weaving or not, and general information of linear, the weld is off, and what the position is. If I move down to the start of a weld, you can see I have my parameters. Again, the crater, the weaving is on, what the width of the weave is, and the frequency. Linear, and we are welding. And again, the position. Our next point, you can see it has the weld off. So this is how we know that the weld is on, the weld is off. Okay. Even with the weaving settings, we're weaving at the start, it's off at the end. So you only have to turn the weave on at the start of the weld. Again, if you want to update any of these settings, you just simply come over to Edit. It gives us our tabs, and we can make changes. And here, once we're done, press Save. And that is the Edit Parameter section. Let's take a look at a couple other useful lines that you may want to insert into your program. I'm going to go to my Lab 1 program, and I'm going to sort from to the recent. And in this case, the most recent is at the bottom of the, is sorted to the bottom. So I'm going to go to Lab 1, open. And we can see we have the start of program. And here's where the approach point for weld one begins. Let's go ahead and put a comment in. And we're going to just call it weld one. And then here's the approach point for number two. So let's go ahead and put another comment in, and we call it weld two. Okay. But what happens if after weld one, I want the robot to wait for a certain amount of time? Let's say 5 seconds. I'm gonna put in the wait command. Let's go 3 seconds. Okay. So now it'll wait 3 seconds before continuing on to weld number two. Let's go ahead and watch that. So here's weld one with the weave. And there's our 3 second wait. And now we're on to the next weld. Okay. The final one is the part count. Okay. So it's just one command, it'll count the part. And what we will do is when we run to auto, we'll watch this counter take place. Okay. So those are a few commands that are available to you: a comment, a wait, and a part counter.